Welcome to this video. In this video, I would like to show you the most important metadata in SAP Materials Management. Enjoy this video and let's get started. The material or the material master is definitely one of the most important metadata in the whole SAP Materials Management module. And in here we are in the transaction code MM03 to display materials. And in here, once you have entered a material ID, manually, or you could also use the for help, then you can select different views. So once you've entered the ID and hit the enter key, then you can select different views. Just for demo purposes, I will select everything, continue, and in here you can enter organizational levels if you want to. I can skip this, and here we see the information of this material. In this case, it's a battery. Here you can maintain the material management and can also move over to different views via this or with the enter key on your keyboard, and there you can look around and get nice details. And as mentioned, for example, for this material ID, you can also make changes in the transaction MM02. There again, once you have entered the ID of this material, hit the enter, there you can select the views that you would like to change. So for example, just the description. So I select the basic data, and in here you can change the description of this material. So for example, just to battery test, and then you can save it, and then you have saved the description of this material. And furthermore, keep in mind that if you would like to add views, then you have to open up the transaction MM01 to create materials. And in here you have to once again enter your material ID, and then you can also select the views that you would like to add, and then you can add new views. Keep in mind, in the MM01 you can create materials, you can add new views, and then the MM02 you can make changes in existing views. And you can also make changes in the transaction MM50. There you can select your materials or just execute the selection, and then for example you can just select the materials that you would like to change, click on maintain materials, and there you can also make changes to materials. So now I would like to give you an overview of the most important transactions regarding materials. So first of all, we've seen the two important transactions, the MM01 to create materials and to add new views to a material. Then you can execute the MM02 to make changes to materials, and then you can execute the transaction code MM03 to display materials. And once again, we've already seen the MM50 to make changes in mass to materials. And if you want to analyze changes to materials, then you can open up the MM04 to display changes to a specific material number. So for example, if I would execute this material ID and execute the selection, then we can see that I have made changes to this material. And if you want to, you can also open up the MM60. It's the material list where you can analyze existing materials. And if you want to, you can also open up the MM06 transaction to flag a material for deletion. And if you want to, you can also do it with the transaction MM70. To archive materials if you want to, and with the important transaction MMBE, there you will get an overview of the stock dependent on the company code plan, storage location, and the batch. And if you want to, you can also open up the MMCC transaction to copy a material. And There are also a lot of important tables regarding materials, and for this I opened up the data browser with the transaction code SE16N. So here we have the table MARA to get a look into the general material data. Then we have the MARC for the plant data for a material. Then we have the MARD for the storage location data for material. Then we have the MVKE for the sales data for material. And then the MARM to the units of measure for a material. Then we've already seen this, the MAKT for the material description, and then the MAPE for the material master export control file, then the MAST, the material for boom link, then the MBEW for the material valuation, and a lot more. I will put you the whole list of the transaction codes and the tables in the video description. I think the next most important master data in SAP MM is definitely the supplier. In the transaction code BP, you can maintain a business partner or a supplier. A supplier is a business partner of a company that supplies goods or offers services. In a supplier master, the most important data of a supplier are stored. There's also general and specific data here. Suppliers are also referred to as vendors in accounting. So, and here, as mentioned, we have a transaction BP to maintain business partners and to compare to SAP ERP, maintaining suppliers or vendors has been changed because in SAP ERP, you have used the transactions MK01 to create a vendor, MK02 to change a vendor, and MK03 to display vendors. And those three transaction codes are obsolete in SAP S/4HANA and are replaced by the transaction code BP. And in here, the main advantage of this transaction is that you define business partner based on different business partner roles, and with these roles you can split the specific data and see in different tabs what you would like to maintain. And I will put in the video description also further very important transaction codes based on suppliers. And for example, if we're opening up the data browser, it's with the SE16N and type in LFA1, there you see, for example, this very important database table that stores the supplier master data, and for example, the LFB1 that stores the company code specific data of a vendor. And again, in the video description, I will put more quite useful tables regarding vendors or suppliers. And definitely the connection of a supplier and a material, the so-called purchasing info record, is one of the most important master data in SAP MM. With a info record, the answer to the question which material can I procure from which vendor at which conditions can be provided. And important informations in an info record are prices, conditions, tolerance limits, availability, vendor evaluations. Materials are procured externally with help of a purchasing info record. And here we are right now in the transaction code ME13 to display a info record. With ME11, you can create an info record, and with ME12, you can change an info record. There are a lot more quite useful transaction codes for info records. I will put it in the video description, and for sure, once again, if we open up the data browser, there are a lot of important tables to info records. So for example, the purchasing info record general data, it's the EINA. Or if you want to, you can open up the EINE to get the purchasing organization data, and so on. Thank you very much for watching. Now I'm interested to get to know what are the most important master data in SAP MM in your opinion, comment under this video and subscribe to not miss any upcoming videos. There will be great videos that help you a lot in your daily work with the SAP system. Thank you very much and see you in the next video.